Hey fams, welcome to another moment. Rianne Wakama, the Certified Relationship and Love Mentor. Today we have a very interesting topic I'd like us to talk about under the relationship repair. And the topic is one rooted reason why relationships fail to avoid. Now, I would be very blunt with you that a lot of people have had sweet relationship in the past, but at the end of the day, this relationship go down. I'm going to be giving you the one rooted reason. But before then, if you're new here, I want to especially welcome you to our TV, and I also want to encourage you to subscribe with the red button below. Also, turn on the notification button, which is by the side of the subscribe button, so that you can get notified of each time we do a post on the our TV. Today, like I said, I'm going to be giving you one rooted reason why a relationship failed. But before then, we'll take a short break, and I want you to stay tuned, and I'll be back shortly. Welcome back. I know you may be surprised to hear a lot of things you'll be hearing today, but if you pay more attention to it, you may never have any cause to have issues in that relationship or in that marriage that would make that relationship or that marriage fail. So I know a lot of people are in relationship, or some that are already in marriage. They've been there for 10 years, 15 years, 20 years. You may be asking yourself, how come people that are married for 10 years, 15 years can still wake up one morning and they tell you we're no longer interested with each other? Now, I'll give you the rooted reason, and it's up to you to make use of this in your life. I've actually made a lot of research, interviewed a lot of couples to really know what this is. Before I proceed, I'm going to be dropping this skeletal drawing, first of all, so that you see it. Then I'll start explaining them one at a time. First of all, I'm going to be giving you the 10 roots of problems you have in marriages or in relationship. But I'll now give you the one rooted one that needs to be uprooted before things can be better. So the first one I'm going to be giving you today is the selfishness root. When both parties are selfless, it becomes very sweet to stay. But when one party is selfish, other parties start changing. The second one is mistake roots. Now, your partner has done a mistake, or your partner has made a mistake, and all you do is to capitalize on that mistake. Even after several apologies, even when you confirm that you've forgiven your partner, you still capitalize on that mistake. This will definitely make your partner start losing interest in you. Third one, disrespect roots. Now, there are different level of disrespect. Disrespect has got degree, trust me. Maybe in subsequent videos I need to teach more on what disrespect is and the degree of disrespect that you can have in relationship and how to avoid them. The degree of disrespect you have for your relationship will determine how your partner will place your relationship. Now, I'll give you an instance. If you are a man and you are a cheat, I tell you, it is so disrespectful to cheat on your partner and to me even make them know that you cheat on them. Now, your partner will not even take that marriage or that relationship very seriously because of the level of disrespect you have for them. You disrespect them to the extent that you brought it to their face. Or you're a woman that each time your partner offends you, you talk to them in front of everybody. It is one high level of disrespect to a man. A man prefers you to use other means to correct him, not using that particular system of attacking him right in front of everybody. So you don't embarrass your partner or nag your partner or behave ill-manner, and you expect your partner to behave nice in that relationship. It will start causing a lot of problem in that relationship. We could lead to the failure of the relationship. Four, distance root. Now, distance root is very sensitive because it has to do with the emotion. Now, a lot of partners are being distant with their spouse or with their partner in terms of emotional, in maybe they are distanced emotionally or physically. Now, if you are distanced physically, probably because of work and all of that, please create time for your family. create a situation whereby you both can live together. That's how to keep your home. If you are not doing anything about it, it could lead to the destruction of that home. Now, the second one is the emotional distance. If you're distancing yourself emotionally with your partner, you don't know what actually goes wrong with your partner, you're not close to your partner, trust me, in a way you start losing them gradually. And if both are missing, the physical and emotional are missing in your relationship or in your marriage, then that particular relationship or that marriage is already at the verge of collapsing. Trust me, it is important that you pay attention to all of this root problem so that it doesn't make your relationship fail. 5, huge expectation. A lot of people go into relationship or marriage because of some high expectations. Okay, you want your partner is a rich guy, you want him to buy a car for you, forgetting that even his car that he's driving, it could be that he's on loan in his company. So all of these are things you need to know. You don't go into a relationship and have so much high expectations, because those people are human too, and they may not be able to meet to your high expectations. Yeah, you should have expectations, but they shouldn't be something that they need to struggle to meet up with. So please take note of this. High expectations could be one root cause that could destroy a beautiful relationship. Number 6, unfaithful roots. This destroy the bricks you have suffered to build in your relationship. You know, relationship basically is like having a building. You have your bricks and you're building the relationship gradually. Now, unfaithfulness just practically kills it. It kills trust. It causes disrespect. It causes a lot of more root problems in a relationship. And this could actually lead to a failure of a relationship. And that's why you need to avoid this unfaithfulness. You need to avoid being unfaithful. 7, compatibility route. Now, I know that a lot of you will be thinking, oh, Anne, I think I think this thing you're saying is, it makes sense. Like, we're not compatible with each other. Now, compatible doesn't mean both of you need to have the same attitude. It only means that both of you need to understand each other. A relationship whereby there is no understanding, I tell you, it could be difficult for both of you to move further. And it's a really big problem that could destroy a relationship if you don't understand each other. No matter how nice that person is to you, if you don't understand yourselves, it could really break that relationship. Number 8, that's money root. Yes, the love of money is the root of all evil, like they say. Yes, money is good. At the same time, money is bad. If you cannot control your love for money, if you can't control your love for money, you end up offending your partner and satisfying that urge for money. When you cherish material things more than your partner, what happens is this. You end up sacrificing all you have to money. And anything that's to do with your partner comes second. Everything that you want to do first lies on money. Any other thing that is pertaining to your partner lies on the second, which is wrong, because money is just like a visitor. It can come to you today, it can go out of your hand tomorrow. So you need to appreciate your relationship so that it doesn't break off. Number 9, distrust roots. This is very difficult because a lot of people distrust their partner based on probably their past life or what one or two things their partner is actually doing to them, which may make one party to end up being curious and sniffing around the other, probably sniffing around their phones, their gadgets and all of that, keeping their partners on their toes. This is wrong. A very good relationship should find peace. A very good relationship should find trust. If you don't have trust, that relationship cannot move. It's going to fail. It may be at the edge of failing. Now, I'm giving you the root causes so that you can understand why some relationships fail even after a long while, and for you to also avoid it. Now, I'm going to be giving you the 10th thing today on the root cause of why some relationships fail even after having a beautiful life. No effort roots. Now, no effort roots is one root cause that people look down on. Now there's a problem in the relationship, you're not putting effort to solve it. Maybe it's only one party that's actually putting in effort to solve that particular issue. You don't need this. It's going to make your relationship fail. The only reason your relationship can move well is when you're putting in effort. Now, being able to give you 10 rules of why some relationship fail, which we're going to be going to the main root cause, that's the number one main root cause of every relationship, number one main root reason why relationship fail, number one main root reason why relationships fail and people ignore. But before I proceed, I have this particular write-up on my blog, which is www.annifepel.com. So please go there to read and share it with other people you know. It could help. Now, the number one reason why relationship fail is unforgiveness. I know you'll be surprised why I'm mentioning this. You may ponder, and why you say unforgiveness? Because really, I have learned over the years that people say they are forgiving others, but they don't sincerely. Because when you forgive someone, you don't expect so much from them. You forgive them genuinely. You don't talk about their mistakes. You're not selfish to them. You don't disrespect them. You don't keep a distance because of what they did to you, and you said you've forgiven them. You don't create huge expectations from them. You don't stay unfaithful with them. You're always faithful, even despite all. You don't cry around telling people you both are not compatible. You don't say, because yes, your partner has offended you once and you've forgiven them, now you don't want to put hope on them anymore. You want to concentrate more on your job, your business, how to fetch money and all of that. You don't say, because they've done something to you, you won't trust them. You don't say you relent to stop putting in effort for your relationship to work. You learn to always put in effort to fix every issue that crops up in your relationship. Now, I've been able to give you this because I want you to look into it and pick this up seriously. You can watch this video over again so that you will know where and where you've actually gone wrong, or where you didn't do well in your relationship, and how to actually avoid this and mend things accordingly. And if you know this video has helped you, I need you to like this video, drop your comments, and share it with others you know. It can help. Trust me, if you have questions, drop them below this video. If you have suggestions, drop them below this video. I want to hear from you. I want to know what you think. And remember to follow us up on all of our social media platforms. Usually we do our videos every Tuesdays, Fridays, and Sundays. I don't want you missing any of our posts, so you stay tuned to Hatara TV to enjoy a lot more of our videos. For you to watch more videos, you can go through the playlist and you see a lot more videos that would play. Thank you all, and I love you.